Yes, sir. You have some really critical information that the voters need to know about. The American people need to know about these people, Cloward and Piven. Can you please elaborate on that?
Well, first, let me give you the website so all of America can find out, because Glenn Beck is trying to get everybody to go out and see. I just Googled this and found this out. DiscoverThenNetworks.org.
Say it again, twice.
www.discoverthennetworks.org. What he's talking about here is you should also follow Saul Alinsky and Cloward and Piven. Let me explain why. Whether it's Bill Ayers or the radicals from the 60s, they all come out of one philosophy. In a moment, I'll explain how Rudy Giuliani back in 1994 exposed this group. This group is Cloward and Piven's strategy on how to bankrupt America by overwhelming the system. And basically what it is trying to take and give money to the underprivileged, getting them for more and more government grants and grants till you overwhelm the system and you shut down Washington, and basically you're bankrupting America. The next stage of that is to socialize the country. Let me take an excerpt from Robert Giuliani, and this I'm quoting back into 1994. Most Americans to this day never heard of Cloward and Piven. But New York City Mayor Rudy Giuliani attempted to expose him in the late 1990s. As his drive for welfare reform gained momentum, Giuliani accused the militant scholars by name, citing the 1966 manifesto as evidence that they had engaged in deliberate economic sabotage. This wasn't an accident, Giuliani charged in 1997. It was an atmosphere thing. It wasn't supernatural. This is a result of policies and programs designed to have the, turn the page, excuse me, Cloward and Piven never again reveal their intentions as candidate as they had in their 1966 article. Even so, the activists' subsequent years continued to rely on the tactics of overloading the system. When public caught on to the welfare scheme, Cloward and Piven simply moved on, applying pressure to other sources of bureaucracy wherever they detected weakness. Let me refrain, unquote. What do you have today with SEIU and Mr. Obama? On July, I believe it was the 3rd or the 8th of July, 2008 in his campaign, I will build a civilian workforce more powerful than our army and as well funded. Nobody knew what Mr. Obama meant by that. Our president is associated with this type of strategy. SEIU, ACORN, was created in the 80s. All of these strategies come from Cloward and Piven to overthrow America over a 100-year period. This is nuts. Okay? And I, as a former New York City person, as in Connecticut, I'm calling out. Glenn Beck will eventually get to this. You will see that, because I believe Glenn is leading there. As far as I'm concerned, you found this out today, and I found this out yesterday. Our country is being subverted. And as far as I'm concerned, we're going to take back the country in 2010. Let me tell you, in Cheshire, Connecticut, you had 22 towns went Republican. Cheshire, where I live, it went totally Republican. And you had Virginia, and you had New Jersey as a start. I guarantee, I think New York City should listen and stop this crap and vote in the next person. As far as I'm concerned, it has to be a conservative. I personally like Sarah Palin for 1,000 reasons, and that's been demonstrated by her vetting process with McCain. And I think she draws more crowds than anyone. Independents are coming over. People have said, I voted for hope and change and I didn't get it. Well, guess what? You're going to get a lot more change if the Democratic Congress is not thrown out, because healthcare takes over America on what you eat and drink and everything you do and how much money you have left. And I don't want to see 70% like France in taxes. This is over starting today.
Very good, sir. Really appreciate your comments. Very good. Thank you.